before I lose power? The talk mostly describes the current setup we have here as a bit of history and a bit of outlook implied. This is mostly boring for many people of you. I'm running Debian since 12 years now, contributing since 5 years, since I attend DevConf. I started contributing a bit earlier and then decided, let's go to DevConf 3. And I do quite a lot of stuff. So one of the things I started last year, Debian Community Org, I completely didn't have any time for it. So if you're interested in the idea of Debian Community Org, please come to me during DevConf and let's talk what we can do there. And since 2005, there's this video team. This talk is not well prepared at all. I did it the last 2 hours because the last days were a bit stressful for me. The two other people who wanted to prepare the talk and give the talk with me are both not here for health reasons. One didn't come to Argentina even. So the idea we had to give this talk were completely overthrown, and 2 hours ago I finally started with it. But I think it's quite well. DevConf 1, DevConf 0, 1 and 2 had talks but no recording as far as I know. I wasn't there. DevConf 3 was recorded and the tapes are still in someone's cellar. So if somebody really wants these videos, they are still available. But there was nothing done with them. And I learned a lot from seeing talks at conferences in general. So I found it a bit frustrating, especially then as I saw that DevConf 4 didn't have any video recordings. We had very nice talks, a wonderful talk by Jeff Bailey, how speakers can improve their talks, which I still want to see again and record this time. And there were other good talks, and they were all only for the limited amount of people who were there. In DevConf 5, we recorded the videos, we released them during DevConf, which was very exhaustive. We basically worked 8 hours or the whole day recording the videos, and in the night post-processed them, because sometimes we had to merge the files together, change audio levels, and I don't know what other work was involved. And after DevConf was finished, the videos were released, and we are also completely exhausted. DevConf 6 we had recordings again. We streamed for the first time, and we created DVDs. We did that for DevConf 5 too. DevConf 6 was video-wise, it worked well, and we managed to keep the post-processing mostly done in Mexico, which was good from the after-work thing. DevConf 7, we had recordings again, streaming, we had camera switching, and no DVDs yet. I don't know, the last recordings were finished last week, and so far no DVDs has been created. What I miss in this talk, because I just realized like really 5 minutes ago, that we used to create the DVDs with a tool called VideoLink, which Ben Hutching also wrote. And VideoLink is very neat because you can create DVDs with a menu structure, with background pictures and everything, navigation, based on an HTML file. So you don't have a graphical user interface to click and point the DVD, but you write it in a text editor and it just gets the files from the directory, which is very nice to automate and to create 3 or 4 DVDs. And this is still possible to do for DevConf 7 or for DevConf 8 videos also, if somebody wants to do that. I'm happy, and Ben is also happy, to explain what needs to be done with VideoLink. I don't think VideoLink is yet in Debian, and I have to look where the source is, but it's somewhere the source is there and it's GPL'd. Yes, as you Probably know by now, we have recording, streaming, we have camera switching again, we have the slide grabber, so you have the slides that we used to film the slides with a video camera, and now we the laptop signal goes to this TwinPack device here, which then goes to the projector and also outputs FireWire. So it's basically a third camera. Yeah, and if we have DVDs, they said that. Since then, we also went to other meetings and recorded them, mostly QA meetings. I don't know why, probably because I went to QA meetings. Since 2005, we've always been recording and now streaming the FOSDEM Debian developer room. Spanish DebConfs, which were now called UTSConf, are also recorded. In general, we also are happy to host other videos from Debian related activities on our archive, which is meetingsarchive.debian.net /pub/debian-meetings, which is linked on this URL. There are about 20 events or so. Sometimes some events with only one or two talks, some with more talks. And this is also, the archive is mostly maintained by Ben and me, and we have not set up a special infrastructure for the archive, we just use the DebConf video mailing list, but it's not DebConf only. Hardware, we started with none. Everything was borrowed from somebody. Somebody had a camera, and we got some microphones, or like now we paid for them, renting them. Then, shortly before FOSDEM, Martin Michelmeier approached me and said that he got a donation by a company, hitflip.de, about 500 euros, which they wanted to donate in hardware, so they didn't want to send the money to SBI to buy hardware for us. And the people, the DSA people, had no use for it, for machines, so Martin thought, he asked the video team if we could buy some stuff. And then I discussed this with the video team, and we decided to buy one of these TwinPack devices to grab the slides. And then we had 100 euros left and bought a small audio mixer. And already before that, at DebConf 7, I talked with Sam Hosever, who was DPL at that time, about using some Debian funds to buy hardware, mostly sound hardware, because the video quality was always good, but the sound was sometimes you could not understand when the audience asked questions, or also the speaker or the mixer were bad. So improving video is, of course, also on our agenda, but first we wanted to get better sound. And I have a slide what we then bought with this Debian money. And we still rely on private hardware a lot, as well as rented hardware. I said this, we got 2,000 euros now from Debian. This is the setup, the audio-video stuff we have here, and which is blue is ours. So we have in each room are two cameras, one TwinPack, two speaker microphones like this one are in this room and one is in the other. We have these wireless microphones to pass around. Condenser mix are the microphones there in the back, which pick up really well the sound, which is good if somebody speaks without a microphone, which happens all the time, even if we try to avoid, and even if speaker try to repeat questions. Then we have speakers and amplifiers, and these two audio mixers. The one there is the rented one, and the one in Microscene is ours. They both have two separate buses. That means that we can control the levels for each microphone independently for the room sound and for the recording. For the room sound, we want to amplify my voice, but we don't want to amplify the condenser microphone because that will give audio loops. And the small mixer I bought for FOSDEM, which was the most sensible thing to do with this 100 euro left, only has one bus, which is still useful for events, which is basically useful for this small room also where you don't use speakers. And the small mixer is perfectly fine. And we used it at FOSDEM and that was useful there. This is our computer setup. It's not, it's the computers and the cameras are there. And this room is covered by Selma, which is the computer at the audio desk there, and Patty is somewhere there. Patty sends the raw DV stream to Selma, which is 25 megabit, and no, it sends two DV streams, so it's 50 megabit, which Patty sends to Selma, and Selma also creates 25 mbit, or has it on the machine. We don't forward that further. Then this DV switch application is running on Selma, where the DV source is selected. What is the output of DV switch then goes to Barney, our file server, where raw DV files are written. So we write 25 megabit per second on Barney, and twice because we have it in the other room. This setup here is quite simple for the hardware and for the network. In Edinburgh, we had four rooms, and therefore we had 100 mbit coming to Barney's disk. Then Selma also sends the raw DV stream to Duffy. That's another 25 megabit on the network, where it's encoded with FFmpeg to Theora. And then Duffy sends that to Lisa, which is our internal Icecast streaming server, which you can access here over the normal video debconf.org URL. And from Lisa, it goes to Krusty, which is a machine, I think, located in the US. Where they're sent to six other streaming servers, which the people outside of DebConf can access. And we have had this morning in Bidel's talk about 180 viewers on these seven external servers, which is a lot better than DebConf 7 in Edinburgh. There we had about 40 to 50 viewers at maximum on 25 servers. Now we cut down to seven servers. And we announced the streams way earlier, and we had test streams running so people could test their client, knew the times. And the setup is also repeated for the MicroScene talk room. The other machine we have is Mr. White, which is the machine with the LCD display in the HackLab here, which is used for monitoring the streams. We usually monitor IRC, and people complain on IRC, the audio is gone, I cannot hear the speaker, whatever. But it's also good to be able to do it here and really check what's going on. Mr. White will also be used for reviewing the files, which I will explain later. So that because we'll watch the raw DV files here, which will also create this 25 mbit bandwidth requirements. So we are sync the files from Barney to Mr. White in the night and during the lunch and afternoon coffee break. And the rate we have here is a 1 terabyte rate, which is now 60% filled or something already, just because in the night we also record it for testing purposes. So what we need to do now or tonight or tomorrow is to delete all the recordings which are unused, because we also record the break, the lunch break, everything is recorded. And 1 hour of DV is 13 gigabytes. And as we record two rooms, we create 26 gigabyte per hour. And that gets filled quite fast. This is the script which is run on Selma. The machine has the Xorg does auto login, so it first starts the DV switch application, then it gets starts one Xterm with DV source FireWire to connect the big camera there. Then it starts two sources. This is the DV sync terminology from Patty, where this camera is connected and the twin packed. And then it starts another source. We can use either FireWire devices as video sources or DV files. And this minus L, it does an endless loop. And then we have the sponsors loop. So we have five sources for the DV switch mixer. And then two syncs are started. Syncs are endpoints for DV switch. One is this file sync on Barney, where it's recorded, and the other is the Icecast streamer on the FFmpeg encoder on Duffy, which then sends it to the Icecast server. And at, in the end, is the IceVM session is started. And something I wanted to add. Yeah, this is, again, the setup in this room with the machines which are related for the recording. Ah, yeah, we also do recording in that camera, in the speaker camera, in case our hard disk recording fails, that we at least have the speaker camera. Of course, we want to have the the recording from DV switch, because we otherwise we don't get the slides, and this all everything we do with DV switch is only on the computer and not in the tape. But last year in Edinburgh we had, I don't know, 70 to 100 talks, and we needed at least 15 tapes. And so because we forgot to turn on the recording in the beginning, or there were other problems, and so far I think these 2 days we are fine without tapes, but I haven't looked at the files, so maybe we'll need more tapes than we thought. DV switch is written by Ben Hutching also. He wrote it for DEPCON 7. It's an Alios project, DV switch. It's not yet in Debian because Ben says it's not stable enough for Debian. We use a bit older branch which was forked, I think, before FOSDEMS. The new branch has overlays, so but it's not stable. So, but for next year, for DEPCONF 9, I assume we can add overlay text to the DV switch, so we can then say in the beginning of the talk, DEPCONF video team talk by Holger Liefsen, and this is displayed in the stream, and other fancy stuff. Because this is the advantage of doing DV switching in software, we can improve our technology every year. We just need FireWire cameras. That is also the CCC, the Chaos Computer Club, its conference. They use analog cameras, and they have much. They cannot do this audio, this video mixing in software, so they need to rent expensive hardware mixers. And by now, I think our setup has become much better than, or is getting to become as good as a professional video mixer setup. I wasn't at LCA, but Eric was, who stood not here today, and he said that the DV switch mixer is already now much better than the hardware mixer they had there, even if the mixer here has some usability problems, like you cannot exchange the two picture-in-picture and the big one, you need to select a new area. So, but this can be fixed in the next release, and then it's really comfortable. This is how DV switch looks like on that computer. The GUI is pretty simple. You just click on this, that, or that to select the main source. You can also press 1, 2, 3, 4. The second button is for the picture-in-picture selection, and the third is for the audio source. But the third, we never change the source because we always send the audio to the main camera. The audio always goes into that camera. And we synchronize the audio and video also in that camera, so that the audio video signal on FireWire is in sync. Otherwise, we would record the video signal on that camera and put the audio somewhere else. Then we would need to sync the audio video, and that basically doesn't work automatically. We would need to do it manually, and then it's a lot of work to do manual audio video sync for 100 hours of video. And so in Edinburgh, really, it was only pressing 1, 2, 3, 4 to select the source. Now with this picture-in-picture option, it gets a bit more complicated. You can either press on picture-in-picture here, then select a region, and select the two sources, press apply, and then the picture-in-picture starts, or turn it off with no effect. And that is everything the video mixer does. There's no more GUI involved. The record button needs to be pressed once when we start in the morning. We press record, which this button can also go away because it's default that we record. And then we only need the cut button, which we press at the beginning and the end of the file, of the talk. So we record out all the time, create files based on the time and date, and if we press cut, a new file is started. Yeah, the streaming is done with OxTheora and OcVorbis, OxTheora video and Vorbis audio. The resolution is quite low, and the video bandwidth also, the bitrate. I think we should maybe turn it up a bit, but would like to discuss this first with the network people and see how much bandwidth we really use. But when I just prepared these slides an hour ago, I was a bit surprised that we use so little bandwidth. I think we can go a bit higher. But it's still watchable on the stream. I'm not sure if the font is small enough to really read it. If we make the bitrate a bit higher, it will be readable. And with the new OxTheora codec, which was released last week, also with those bandwidths, it should work. But that's next year again. We record raw DV files, so we record with 570 to 720 or something. So there, even smaller fonts are readable. But this morning in Martin Ferrari's talk about the Perl group, I saw it on the stream and couldn't really read his screenshots, and I know that they will be readable in the high resolution recording. We have seven relays, four in Europe, two in North America, and one in Australia, which apparently is enough. I have not heard problems from people who said they cannot really access the streams, or they cannot they get connection lost. That is also the advantage of streaming with such a low bandwidth, that more people have the bandwidth to see the streams. And the really important thing when you see it live is the audio. That's mostly the important stuff. There are some player issues, several. At first that we started, I couldn't see the video on my laptop on any of the popular video clients. I could hear the sound but not see. I had green or blue image. Then I changed the XORG driver and had video. And people complain about this all the time on the IRC channels. There are some documented on this URL, depconf8 streams. If you know them, or it's helpful if you file bugs for these issues and probably fix them. There's quite some stuff. Yeah, post-processing sucks really, really badly, because after this conference, I will be completely exhausted, don't want to think about video for the next month, basically. And so you don't want to do that after the event, really. You have to do it if you don't finish here. I think probably the last day, because the conference ends on Saturday and we all go to Buenos Aires on Sunday, so probably I'm not sure if we'll manage to get Saturday done, but I want to really have the other 6 days be done here. So I want post-processing is needed. The recording there is not usable completely, but it should be done during the conference. So we have this nice workflow, which is implemented mostly in PentaBAF, the conference management system. And this is from the documentation Tassia wrote. So if people who help us help the video team to review files, it's all nicely documented now. Each file automatically gets imported into the video controller in PentaBAF. I think I can show that here if I would knew how to switch. Anyway, so in PentaBAF there's a list of DV files where the only thing is there's the time and the date. And then you get this video controller in Penta if you're in the video group. So if you want to help us, you need to come to me or to the DepConf admin and get added to the video group in PentaBAF. Then you can associate a file with an event, say this recording which started at that time, that was this talk. Then you review the DV file you mount from an NFS server, that is Mr. White, the machine here, the video directory. Then you say in Penta, okay, the recording is good, this the quality is acceptable. And note the start and the end time, because with this pressing cut, the video mixer usually presses cut for whatever, 5 seconds too early, or not, probably not too early, probably in time, but sometimes he forgets to press cut, and so there's in the beginning there's 10 minutes of people walking into the room talking, which we don't want, and the same at the end. So you note these times in Pentabath. Then the files automatically get encoded in 4 versions: good quality Octiora, bad quality Octiora, or good high resolution and not so high resolution, and the same with MPEG files, MPEG 1 to create DVDs. So there are PAL and NTSC MPEG files created. That happens automatically in the night. Then these files have to be reviewed again and rated in Penta, say, yeah, the encoding was fine, audio, video is in sync. And then you mark it in Penta that it was is fine, and then it gets automatically uploaded to the meetings archive, and a post for our RSS feed is created. The RSS feed is included on planetdebian.org, so hopefully we'll flood Planet this week with 70 posts, with one for each event. And this was mostly done by Damian. He also did it last year in Edinburgh, had to rewrite it then because the Pentabath code base changed a lot. And now we'll try to get this into the Pentabath upstream merge so that next year we can have it again without so much work. And for reviewing the files is not so hard. You don't have to watch the whole talk again. It's mostly enough to watch in the beginning to see which has to be cut at in the end, and check in the middle that the audio video is always in sync. You usually don't watch the whole talk again. La la la. Open Office and an unconfigured awesome don't like each other. Not at all. Ah, was it? The DV switch is an own Alios project, which is really just the software. We have another Alios project, DEPCON Video, for the DEPCON Video package and for our talks and for other stuff. This DEPCON Video package creates 4 binary packages, I think, with the scripts for the DV sources and syncs. So this, the camera and the is the source, and the sync is this sending the file either to the file server or to the Icecast server. Then we have scripts for Pentabath to import these files into the Pentabath database and do the encoding, uploading, and creating the RSS feed. And the configuration files for the 8 machines for DV switch are also there. DV switch has its own configuration. Where are the sources? Where are the syncs? And the second, your SVN URL is wrong. Should be phi config in the end. Phi is this fully automatic installation tool for, which is in Debian. And it's not only about installation, it's also for maintaining an infrastructure. These machines here were installed manually with Debian installer, just a base system. And then I ran a script on it to apply the configuration with phi. I had also prepared USB sticks, which made the DI install automatic method and then started the Phi soft update after it. But I only had USB stick how to create the USB stick and not an image. So the local team decided they install Debian manually, or it was also because we said we would reinstall and then didn't do it. But it's after the base system installation, everything is automated, and it also integrates the Debcon video package has configuration for all the 8 machines and the Icecast servers, and this is all applied with this one fire update.
Are the two URLs supposed to be the same one?
No. Okay. The second one should be, instead of package in the end, it's file config. But you can just check out the one, the Debcon video repository. The video team this year is quite big, the extended team. The first row is the people who worked on setting up DebCamp and made everything. The second row is people who are not really in the video team but helped us a lot, especially the network admins and Maxi and Zero, who did a lot of work for the video team here. Then there are local volunteers who yesterday came and said, yay, we want to help you. And because in the past, often people thanked me for the video streams, and it was always a teamwork, I've now set up this thanks wiki page where I would like you to add your thanks instead of telling it on IRC or whatever, because it's really nice just in a month to look at it, to know that we achieved something which made possible for people to watch this conference. Yeah, really, please add your note there. In the future, the FOSDEM is a good event for us to test stuff, because most video team members are living in Europe and are going to FOSDEM. So, and it's only one day, which is also helpful. We can just... Right. and then for DebConf 9 is there again, where I hope we'll further polish the setup. And you can use this DebConf 9 URL already now to add wishlist stuff. Just add it on this page. We'll look at this page next year again. That worked really well last year after DebConf 8. We talked on IRC what we did was well and not so well in DebConf 7 in Edinburgh. And we prefixed everything with DC8 wishlist. And a month ago, I grabbed in the IRC logs for DC8 wishlist and put that all in a wiki page, and then we discussed that in our IRC meeting. And that was really helpful to see what we learned from last year. So if you want to complain, please use this page. If you want to say thanks, use the other one. We have this /video team or the DebConf8/video team/help wiki page, which is documentation for the volunteers about the review, or link to the review documentation and to the cheat sheets, how to operate the camera, how to operate this TwinView device, how to operate the video mixers, what to take a look at the microphones. What we haven't done yet so far is making these cheat sheets, which are in the wiki, in a bringing them into a printable form, so that we can put them next to the camera. So, because nobody who's operating the camera will look at the wiki page, doesn't work. So we need to print them and laminate them, and this hasn't been done yet. There's also still some stuff in the to-do, which is mostly there. It's harder to help. And in general, we have this DebConf 8 video team category in the wiki where all our pages are linked. And basically everything is documented in the wiki or in this SVN repository. Yep, that was it. Thanks for listening. Any questions, suggestions, comments? Okay.